Hi, I'm Dr. Deb Sandella, founder of the RIM Institute and author of Goodbye, Hurt, and Pain. Did you know that chronic stress increases our chances of having a stroke or a mini stroke by 59%? That's significant. Yes, our mind and our body, our emotions and our health are intricately interwoven. And so I'm going to teach you today about a way to to sense the sensation in the body to uncover the root of an emotional issue so that it can be resolved. So then both mind and body thrive. And this process shifts you from your left brain thinker to your right brain feeler. So once we're in the right brain, it directly connects to the body memory and to feelings that have begun in the body. So it's like following the trail back to the root problem. And so the way this works is to just very simply close your eyes, or you can have your eyes partially open if you like. And begin to have your attention move down into your body. And as your attention drops down into your body, wherever it wants to go, and if it's ambivalent, just go ahead and let it drop in right behind your belly button, right there in your belly. And as you're there, you're going to be able to sense just the inside of your body and whatever is calling your attention. So what is it that you're noticing first, either inside or around your body? And go ahead and focus on it. And as you focus on it, you'll just notice how big or small it is. You'll notice what color your imagination is giving it right now. You'll notice the kind of texture that this area has, and whether it is a specific shape of energy or whether it's just amorphous. And as you sense all of that, there'll probably be new and more details that are unique to you that will show up. And as they do, go ahead and sense them, receive them, and whatever aspect of that energy seems the strongest to you, like it's calling your attention the most, move your awareness into it and just be with it, allow it just as best as you can. And as you do, there'll be one word that pops into your awareness of what you're feeling in this energy, in this space. It'll just come in, just allow it, receive it. And then rest in it and be in it. Whatever that energy, that energetic feeling is. And as you're in it, you'll notice that it very naturally begins to fade or dissipate. Because when we move into that is a feeling state that we haven't been acknowledging. When we acknowledge it, when we move into it energetically, it begins to dissolve. And so just notice, as you're ready, how that feels now. And as it feels significantly decreased or gone, go ahead, you can open your eyes partially or all the way, it's up to you. As you notice how your body tells you what you're experiencing. Now, this was just a little taste of what can happen. For instance, last night I was working with a young man on the phone who was making a job decision of whether to change jobs or not. And as he did the body sensing, it was his left kneecap that actually drew his attention the most. And as we explored the details of that kneecap, It was very thick, it was dark blue, and it was moldy. So as we sense the moldy, as he sensed that moldy quality, he moved into it. I asked him to go ahead and move his attention into the moldiness, the very moldiest part of it, because that's what we want. That's where the best information is about the insight that that's hiding here. And as he did, we asked for a number, whatever number popped into his mind first, and it was 3 years. 3 years ago. And as he became aware, well, that was when he started working at the current job, we ask his imagination for an image of the source of the problem there, just like that. And the face of his boss showed up, of his current boss. And as he saw the face of his current boss, all of the deep visceral feelings that had been being collected in his gut since he had been under this boss became very clear and very uncomfortable because he hadn't been consciously aware of them until now. But now he was consciously aware of them and they were in his body. We don't want mold in our bodies. And so now, having uncovered the source of the problem, we could generate a new movie in his emotional memory of actually speaking to his boss in a way that he never had before, by being honest and letting him know that he felt diminished, that he did not feel like he was being empowered to be the best employee that he could be, and that this was very disturbing to him. It was really interfering with his job satisfaction and also with his performance. And as he had that conversation, it was just so enlightening that as he spoke, the more and more he spoke those feelings, the stronger and stronger he felt. And he realized he had actually given up his voice since he had been working with this boss, this manager. And in that moment, he regained his voice. And that's a world of difference. And so I want you to know that you too are resourced very deep in your body in a way that you haven't recognized before, probably, and maybe you have. Whether you have or not, it's really important for us to constantly remember to access that part of ourselves that is resourced and capable. And so thank you for being with me, and I look forward to seeing you again.